Thank you very much. Good afternoon, everybody. I would like to thank the organizers for giving me this opportunity, and I don't know how to illustrate microbes for you because they are not visible. They are very invisible life forms, but I will try my best. First of all, I think the demonstration which was made before in IBC, it is common. We are doing this for the last 4 or 5 years. So I think it's a good experience to show how to just clean waste products or pollutants. At the same time, I'm just going to present, there is also a hope to degrade plastics using microorganisms. Let me start. I think I'll try to focus on these issues. The first one is the definition, what are microbes, and then what is believed about microbial diversity, and what has been done so far in Ethiopia, and then threats and challenges. Of course, they are very well known, but I will try to show what threats and challenges, and then the way forward. First of all, when we talk about microbes, we know that they are very microscopic and unseen microorganisms. That doesn't mean they don't have any importance in the ecosystem, in the world, for the benefit. They are not work. It doesn't mean that they are not working for the benefit of the ecosystem or for humankind. Yeah, don't know. Yeah. The term microbes, especially at this time, because before microbes are the definition of the use of the word is almost connected with pathogens, but nowadays the word microbes stands for those microorganisms which are not seen with naked eyes. Those are bacteria, archaea, fungi, microalgae, protozoa, and also viruses. Almost all these microorganisms of these unseen elements are named as microbes. The other one is, when we talk about microbes, always we have to know that they are the first colonizer of our Earth. The first life forms existed on Earth. Even after their existence, after 2.4 billion years, the other microorganisms came to the world. It is believed that after 100 million years of our Earth's birth, the microorganisms came to colonize our Earth, and they are believed that they are the engineers of the of our Earth to invite other life forms. Likewise, microbial world encompasses millions of genes from thousands of species with thousands and hundreds of proteins and multimolecular machines operating in a web of hundreds of interacting processes in response to numerous physical and chemical environmental variables. This is the advantage of microorganisms to live in different ecosystems with extreme environmental situations, and also they are harboring different geographical locations. Each individual microbe is but at almost weightless. We know that they are very minute. They are not visible with naked eye, and they are very small, than 1/100 of our hair. So one cell organism, the collective weight of Earth's 5 million trillion trillion, or 5 nonillion microbes, accounts for the most of the planet's biomass. Maybe somebody estimates microbes in millions, but it is believed that 5 or 1 followed by 30 zero. Their number is that much huge, and their collective power is really not comparable with any life form. As we know that, even though this number is already estimated, that microbes are such amount, but the decoded genomes of microorganisms is not more than 2,000 microbial species because of different problems. What is believed about microbial diversity? It is believed that the conventional view of microbial distribution of species through space and time has been dominated for decades by the hypothesis Busbecking. Lawrence Busbecking is a botanist and a microbiologist. He's a Dutch scientist. He's well known for the theory of Busbecking hypothesis. He believed everything is everywhere, but the environment selects. The theory, based on the dependence of microorganisms on different geographic distributions over the Earth, on their metabolic properties. But the truth is, they are independent to live in every ecosystem. As far as if that ecosystem will kiss, they will just adapt themselves to another ecosystem. So they are not dependent, but they are independent from different aspects. Because of their collective life style and because of their different gene properties, because it is known that microbes are holding millions and billions of genes, and they are just exchanging these genes when they need to adapt to a specific environment. Because of this, they are independent in a given ecosystem. That doesn't mean that they are not specific for a given ecosystem. It is believed that they are living in different ecosystems. They have a very high adaptability in that ecosystem. But if that ecosystem is not exist, they will change themselves to another ecosystem. This is already proved in laboratory. For example, when we take Pseudomonas, Pseudomonas is growing on nutrient agar. But if we just push him to utilize plastic by starving this species, Pseudomonas will eat plastic. That's why we have hope to decompose plastic in the environment using Pseudomonas species. Because of this theory, for a long period of time, there is a big problem, or there is a gap, to not consider microbial biodiversity for conservation and utilization strategy. The omission of microbial community in management and conservation of ecosystems, because of this theory, led to assume that microbial community are insensitive, resilient, and redundant. So no need of just conserving microbial biodiversity and manage them for better use in every country for their development and other activities. So that's why, for a long period of time, microbial diversity is neglected and not conserved in every country, in most of the countries, especially in developing countries, for their different purposes. We know that no corner of Earth escapes the influence of microorganisms. For instance, we know that there are many microbial species living in heat environment. We say them heat lovers, or swimming in heat. Others are living in cold environment. Others are living in alkaline salt environment, acid environment, and in deep sea, in dry areas, in dumps. Even they are resisting blasts. They are not just dying in 1,000 blast UV. They are flying in the space. We know that they are aging well. The discovery, current discovery showed that there are microbes who already lived about 350 million years. So with this all, we know that microbes are everywhere and are restive engineers of our environment, starting from our guts, starting from our skin. They are just regulating working with us for thermoregulation. They are working with us for breakdown of different food items. They are working with us in fermentation process. They are working with us in different activities. So with this, they are everywhere. They are working with us. They are very important, and they are known as engineers of our planet. So with this all, what has been done so far in Ethiopia? The first step of or the milestone that has been done in our country is the recognition of microbial diversity to be explored, collected, conserved, utilized as one of the priority area in which are necessary for the sustainable development of the country. That means this is addressed during the establishment of Ethiopian Biodiversity Institute or Institute of Biodiversity Conservation and Research under the proclamation of 120/1998. Then after, the birth of current microbial biodiversity was in 1991. We started to work on microbial biodiversity since 1999. And then we have a lot of activities carried out since this time. But before that, there are various institutions carrying out different related activities based on microbial biodiversity, especially Addis Ababa University. Sorry. Wow. Yeah, Addis Ababa University, Haramai University, Hawassa University, Jimma University, Gondar, Mekele University, Ethiopian Armour Hansen Research Institute, Ethiopian Agricultural Research Institute, Institute of Agricultural Research, and others. But the problem was, there are significant efforts at that time, but little has been done in a concerned way and integrated way on microbial biodiversity. Since that time, we have evidences that about 200 genera and 445 species of bacteria, fungi, algae, protozoa, virus were isolated, but they are not conserved. So far, after the birth of our institute, especially this department, we tried to organize these efforts and also work on exploration, isolation, identification, characterization, and conservation of microbial biodiversity. What has been done since 1999? First of all, we try, because we don't have really a good background before that, and we started to collect samples from different ecosystems. So until now, we tried to collect about 19,694 samples from different ecosystems, including Dalol, Ertale, and highlands of Ethiopia. At the same time, we tried to identify about 605 different species, that bacterial and fungal species, using conventional microbiology techniques, and as well biolog. Now, at this time, we are just looking for MySeq system, Illumina. We have that technology in our institute. So next time, maybe we will have evidences on microbial diversity in the country. The other one is we try to characterize different microbial species or according to their importance, especially microbes used for fermentation, microbes used for growth promotion, microbes used for biodegradation. So we have a lot of microbes characterized in our institute based on their activities. The other one is we are already conserved 605 species in ex situ, and three, we have also three in situ sites, because you know that I will come later. The best way of conserving microorganisms, because they are not well known, there are very challenging aspects of just having microbes for conservation and utilization, because there are inadequate technologies to study the microbial diversity, even for their identification. So it is very important to conserve the ecosystem as a whole, where it is believed that there are very important microorganisms, especially in our country, Rift Valleys and hot thermal areas. They are very important. As far as we will just get appropriate technologies, maybe we'll define which microorganisms are there. So because of this, we already try to conserve microbes in their habitat, that is in situ conservation. The other one is we have research activities, as I said, based on their usefulness. And the other one is we have already distributed about 41 species until now. Let us see our exploration in different ecosystems. The first one is in Dalol. Dalol is very extreme environment. As I said, it is believed that it has 126 below sea level. We already measured this amount in Afdera. The other one is, as you know, that Dalol is very extreme environment. There are many acid lakes. These are really very beautiful, but they are very strong acids. Even when we measured them, the pH meter measured negative 0.6. That means below 1. So it's very strong acid. You know, there are a lot of architectures in the loan. When the sulfide gas is already evaporated, the remaining are really very exciting architectures. As you see, even we have also the map of Africa, unfortunately. So there are a lot of exciting event features in Dalol. So our team was there to collect different samples from different areas, almost all over the Dalol. This is what we did also in Afdera. Afdera is known as a salt lake, because most of us, we know that we have Afdera salt in our kitchen. A lot of people are using that salt. So it's very salty, and the depression is minus 126 in Afdera. This is also thermal vents in Silte area. I want to show you where we were and what we collected. These are very exciting. We tried to touch every corner of the country as far as possible, and we tried to collect different samples from different areas and different ecosystem, including life forms and soil samples. This is what we have in different regions of the country. The other one is threats and challenges. As you know, that very little is known about microbial diversity in Ethiopia. This is because of different gaps. The first one is lack of integrated conservation and research efforts. The other one is culture collection center, even at national level. The other one is conservation facilities, awareness on the value of microbes, skilled manpower. Lack of these elements hindered the value of microbial diversity, not only in Ethiopia, but worldwide. The other one is inadequate microbial diversity assessment. This needs, as you know, that very very special technologies for their recovery, isolation in the culture. We know that from that very huge number, only 1% of microbes are culturable. From this culturable, only 2,000 microbes are already encoded in laboratory. So the technology is very weak, and the number of microbes is very huge, especially even in one species with different strains. There are different gene pools, and variation is very high. So for this, we need really very high throughput sequence technologies and bioinformatics plus skilled manpower. So with this all, there is inadequate information on microbial diversity and even on their importance, because identifying the species is not the the final target. After identification, we have to know what metabolites, what enzymes, what they have in to use in different in different activities. The other one is, as you know, that even it is impossible to predict the extinction of microorganisms, because as other life forms, it is impossible to detect or to have any direct evidence on their fossil records. Because of this, even we don't know whether they are extincting or not. We believe that they have a huge amount of genes and just circulating between themselves. It is believed that they have the ability to adapt to a new environment, even if the environment is already destroyed. So with this, maybe the extinction of microbes is very, very limited. It doesn't mean that they are the same when the environment is changed, but it's believed that the extinction is very limited. So we need high throughput sequence technologies and skilled manpower. The other one is, the main challenge for microbial conservation is to determine what should be conserved and where. So setting priority is very important in this aspect. In our case, we had already priorities. We are conserving and collecting and identifying and conserving microorganisms, or especially microbial species, important for agriculture, medicine, industry, and the environment. Unless otherwise, it's very difficult to conserve all everywhere, because they are everywhere, they are all. So this is one of the challenges, and I think it is very important to understand what to conserve in ex situ and what to conserve in in situ. It's really believed that as far as the ecosystem is protected, conserved, microbes are also conserved, because they are specializing to that ecosystem. So it is believed that when the ecosystem is existing, we know that microbes will continue with their existence, with their function and interaction. So in our case, as I said, we have having established reasons for conservation of microbes, that is conservation priority. Our priority is to conserve microbial species important for agriculture, medicine, industry, and environment. Especially when I said industry, from traditional to modern industry, from fermentation in our house to industrial processes to produce beer or other products. With this, I left the last slide, because we know that we have to have a human resource, we have to have technologies, what I said, and nothing is done unless otherwise we have really the technology and the skill manpower. But we know that they are very important. We have to explore, conserve them, but with these facilities. That's why I just jumped the last slide.